Welcome by Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart.
Today's topic is really simple. Let's make this huge Panasonic camera working on this dual CPU Windows NT workstation with the Matrox G200 Marvel video card.
This is the Matrox Marvel box and it is the breakout box which is connected to the Matrox G200 video card. And here you can see all kinds of inputs to capture video. And here on the back, if you can see, you have also outputs for video and some coax outputs. So it's a really handy box. First we're gonna install the software. Here we have the driver and here we have the tools. And I downloaded it from the Matrox website. Okay, we unzip the files and we run the setup. Matrox video software setup. Nice. Next, 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 next. And of course, this is Windows NT, so we need to restart our computer. Let's start up the Matrox PC VCR remote software. And I never used this software before, so I'm not sure how it works. But here it looks like a window for the video input. And here's some kind of a remote to control it. So this is really home user software. Let's check out this monster of a camera. I bought this camera for 10 euros on a flea market. The camera came with a Canon zoom lens and it has a B4 mount, so we can remove it. Here we have a zoom rocker. Here we can adjust the aperture. And here we set the focus. Also, the camera came with a black and white viewfinder. On the back, normally there's a battery, but my unit came with a power supply with a normal power connector. The most fun thing about this camera is it's really huge, but there's not even a recorder inside. To use this with a recorder, you need to attach a very big cable here with a recorder hanging to your side. So this was a very heavy setup. And here on the other side we have an XLR audio input, external DC plug with a 4-pin XLR, and here another XLR with a microphone clamp. If you like cameras, lenses and filmmaking, please subscribe to my other channel, Dutch Video Shooter. I really need 1000 subscribers on that channel and we are now at 750, so we are getting close. All the help is welcome. So let's connect the Matrox Marvel to the Panasonic Pay3, but we have only coax connectors on this unit and no coax on the Matrox box. But we have this little converter which converts it in something we can use. I have a nice cable, so plug that in. Plug that in the video input. Okay, let's power the camera. Let's see, which button was it? There are a lot of buttons and I'm not that familiar with this camera, but it is a working unit. Okay, we have an on-off switch on the power supply. Standby operate. Nothing. Oh wait, external battery, AC adapter off, external battery. Ah, we have a green light here. Okay, from standby to operate. Okay, my viewfinder is now on, but I'm now seeing the computer case. Oh wait, the ND filter is now on close to save the sensor inside. So let's see, we need to set it to 1. And when I'm turning the ND wheel, you already see that it's adjusting the exposure. Okay, I have an image in my viewfinder. But I need to get the camera higher up. Okay, zoom out. Yes, I have a nice image here. Focus peaking on. Yes, this camera has focus peaking. Very nice. Okay, we are having an image now. Here's the button for automatic iris of manual. I have set iris to manual, so I now can adjust the exposure myself. And also this camera has zebras in the viewfinder. Okay, the camera is up and running now, so let's see how this software works. Line. Hey, it's working! Yes! Awesome! Oh, this is so cool and it looks really nice. Where's the record button? Is this the record button? Okay, we captured just a single JPEG image from the camera. And you can see it's pretty decent for an 80s camera on 1999 hardware. How do we capture video with this? Let me see. Video. Composite. Yes, Paul, that is correct. Capture options. Let's try one of the other settings. Hey, composite, and now we have a timer. Captured 423 frames, null are dropped. The file size is 63 megabyte, and the media length is 16 seconds. And the video format is 320 by 240. Yes, we captured something with this camera. It's really awesome that this 80s Panasonic P3 camera still works today and that we can capture it with this Matrox Marvel unit on old Celeron hardware to a SCSI drive. It's amazing! I love this! Let's do a studio tour in style, and I hope that the video cable is not falling out because the connection is not that strong. Okay, press record. And the nice thing about this camera that it is made to put on your shoulder. Okay, let's sync the cameras. Okay, here we have the Abit BP6 with dual Celeron 366 workstation. Here we have the Aope Big Tower. And here we have an empty case. I didn't build yet in that case. Here we have my test system with an Intel Pentium 3. Here we have my secret project. And I can't give you any info about it. This is my old 2006 workstation. And here are some projects that I need to start on. This is my camera where I film all my videos with. And it is the Panasonic GH5 and it shoots 4K. This camera is heavy. My back is hurting now. But it's so awesome that it works on this machine. And the funny thing is, you can probably get more quality and easier setup with this little USB capture card thingy. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can check out Retro Machines on Facebook and please support me on Patreon. And for more camera stuff, please go to my second channel, Dutch Video Shooter.
A reminder that the Black Mesa Hazard Course Decathlon will commence this evening at 1900 hours in the Level 3 facility. The semifinals for high security personnel will be announced in a separate secure access transmission.